Teach our hearts to love like yours, love of God most high, Sacred Heart of Jesus, keep us by your side, save us all from death and sin. Grant us grace and all good gifts, Heart of Christ our Lord. Make your holy presence our home evermore. Fill us with your light and life, guide us in your way. Justice, peace, and
the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, give me strength. Heal me, Jesus. Hide me in thy wounds, that I may never leave thy side. From all the evil that surrounds me, defend me.
Teach our hearts to love like yours, love of God most high, Sacred Heart of Jesus, keep us by your side. Save us all from death and sin, our King crucified. Grant us grace and all good gifts, Heart of Christ our Lord. Make your holy presence our home evermore. Fill us with your light and life, guide us in your way. Always yours and for
Honor of the heart of Jesus, who dearly loves us, let us pray the litany of the Sacred Heart. Please kneel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Litany to the Sacred Heart. Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, hear us. Christ, graciously hear us. God the Father in heaven, God the Son, Redeemer of the world, God the Holy Spirit, Holy Trinity, one God, Heart of Jesus, Son of the Eternal Father, Heart of Jesus, formed by the Holy Spirit in the womb of the Virgin Mother. Heart of Jesus, one with the eternal Word. Heart of Jesus, infinite in majesty. Heart of Jesus, holy temple of God. Heart of Jesus, tabernacle of the Most High. Heart of Jesus, house of God and gate of heaven. Heart of Jesus, aflame with love for us. Heart of Jesus, source of justice and love. Heart of Jesus, full of goodness and love. Heart of Jesus, wellspring of all virtues. Heart of Jesus, worthy of all praise. Heart of Jesus, King and center of all hearts. Heart of Jesus, treasure, house of wisdom and knowledge. Heart of Jesus, in whom there dwells the fullness of God. Heart of Jesus, in whom the Father is well pleased. Heart of Jesus, from whose fullness we all received. Heart of Jesus, desire of the eternal hills. Heart of Jesus, patient and full of mercy. Heart of Jesus, generous to all who turn to you. Heart of Jesus, fountain of life and holiness. Heart of Jesus, atonement for our sins. Heart of Jesus, overwhelmed with insults. Heart of Jesus, broken for our sins. Heart of Jesus, obedient even to death. Heart of Jesus, pierced by a lance. Heart of Jesus, source of all consolation. Heart of Jesus, our life and resurrection. Heart of Jesus, our peace and reconciliation. Heart of Jesus, victim for our sins. Heart of Jesus, salvation of all who trust in you. Heart of Jesus, hope of all who die in you. Heart of Jesus, delight of all saints. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, Jesus, gentle and humble of heart, touch our hearts and make them like your own. Let us pray. O Almighty and Eternal God, look upon the heart of your dearly beloved Son and upon the praise and satisfaction he offers you in behalf of sinners, and being appeased, grant pardon to those who seek your mercy. In the name of the same Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated.
Ika nga ng isang sikat na superhero, ang great power may kasama ring great responsibility. Bata pa lang si Benigno Simeon Aquino III. Wala pa siyang great power. Pero, meron na siyang great responsibility. Ang maging ilaw para sa kanyang mga mahal sa buhay tuwing ang paligid ay madilim. Ang magsilbing ilaw para sa mga taong nakapaligid at lubos na nakakakilala sa Kanya. Iyan ang great power ni Noy Noy, ang kanyang liwanag. Pinoy's light was special. Dahil hindi man ito ubod ng laki, o high voltage ang lakas. Ramdam ito ng lahat. At nang dumating ang panahon na kailangan niyang tanglawan ang buong bayan, pinilit niyang maghatid ng pagbabago at pag-asa sa abot ng kanyang makakaya. Bila ng bawat pagsubok.
Pinagmalaki ni Pangulong Aquino ang paglago ng ekonomiya ng Pilipinas.
Each and every Filipino enjoys the full dividends of progress.
Nilagdaan na ni Pangulong Noynoy Aquino ang Enhanced Basic Education Act of 2012.
Sagot ang programa para mapataas ang kalidad ng edukasyon sa ating bansa.
Ikinalulungkot kong iurat sa inyo, tuloy-tuloy ang modernisasyon ng AFP.
Kumbinsido tayong makakamtan natin ang patong-patong na positibong bunga ng yugtong ito ng Skyway.
Nag-ipot si Pangulong Aquino sa itinatayong bagong paliparan sa Puerto Princesa, Palawan.
Ipinagtanggol ni Pangulong Noynoy Aquino ang karapatan ng Pilipinas sa pinag-aagawang teritoryo sa West Philippine Sea.
Nagbunyi ang iba't ibang bahagi ng Mindanao sa makasaysayang paglagda ng Comprehensive Agreement on the Bangsa Moro.
Ipinagmalaki ni Pangulong Noynoy Aquino ang pagbabaraw ng bilang ng mga Pilipinong naghihirap.
Hindi po biro ang ipinuhunan natin para sa pantawid pamilya. Taon-taon nating tinaasan ang pondo ng pantawid pamilya.
Isang taon na mula nang nawala ang ilaw ni Pinoy. Pero nananatili ang init at kislap nito. That's the great power of a great man who bravely and wholeheartedly fulfilled his great responsibilities.
Pag tinitingnan ko nga po ang lahat ng nakamit natin at ang konkretong patunay nito, talagang naiisip ko na sulit ang lahat ng pagod, pang-aalipusta at pagyurak na ating kinakaharap bilang Pangulo.
Once again, a blessed morning. For those joining us physically in the church, here are a few reminders before we begin the celebration. All must wear their face mask at all times. Please observe physical distancing and follow the designated labels on the pews. Please use the glass doors at the side as exit doors when leaving the church or using the comfort rooms. Please turn off your cell phones or switch them to silent mode to maintain the solemnity of our Eucharistic celebration. Dear brothers and sisters, we welcome you in the Church of the Gesù here at the Ateneo de Manila University. Today, the entire church celebrates the feast of God's great love for us, the solemnity of the most sacred heart of Jesus. God's unconditional love never tires to call us into his fold. May we heed his call of love and mercy. In this Eucharistic celebration, we also remember in a special way and with deep gratitude the passing on of former President Noynoy Aquino, a man who, from the moment he said yes to the mission of serving as the chief executive, became a channel of God's love and mercy to heal our broken and wounded nation. May his soul be purified and gain entrance into the blessedness of heaven. May all of us left behind be transfigured and Christified as we continue to give our soul, feelings, thoughts, words, actions, and joys to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Our presider for the celebration is Father Roberto C. Yap of the Society of Jesus, President of the Ateneo de Manila University, and our homilist is Father Jose Ramon T. Villarin S.J. Joining him in the Mass are his brother Jesuits. Let us all stand and sing as we begin the celebration of the Holy Mass. Thank you.
panahon tayo'y inalipin, nang ngalan niya'y ating sambitin, paanong di tayo linyapin? Ayan muling mag-ipon, awitan ng Panginoon, sakit yung sariwain.
My sisters and brothers, we gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today is the feast of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. The Sacred Heart is symbol supreme that God is love. Love is all that God is. He's not loving to some and not to others. No act of ours can possibly make him stop loving us. The Sacred Heart is symbol supreme of God's inexhaustible mercy, unfailing forgiveness, limitless compassion, overwhelming kindness. It is very beautiful that we remember President Noy on his first death anniversary this year during the Feast of the Sacred Heart. We entrust President Noy to the Sacred Heart, to God's infinite mercy, God's boundless compassion, and extraordinary kindness. We also ask that we be rooted and grounded in God's love, so our hearts may be inflamed with true love for country, that we may have strength and courage in standing up for the truth, for justice, and for the common good. My dear friends, to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us now give glory to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Jesus Christ, only begotten, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father. You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, in the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who glory in the heart of your beloved Son and recall the wonders of his love for us may be made worthy to receive an overwhelming measure of God's grace from that fount of heavenly gifts to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated for the liturgy of the word.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, I myself will look after and tend my sheep, as a shepherd tends his flock. When he finds himself among his scattered sheep, so will I tend my sheep. I will rescue them from every place where they were scattered when it was cloudy and dark. I will lead them out from among the peoples and gather them from the foreign lands. I will bring them back to their own country and pasture them upon the mountains of Israel, in the land's ravines and all its inhabited places. In good pastures will I pasture them, and on the mountain heights of Israel shall be their grazing ground. There they shall lie down on good grazing ground, and in rich pastures shall they be pastured on the mountains of Israel. I myself will pasture my sheep. I myself will give them rest, says the Lord God. The lost I will seek out, the strayed I will bring back, the injured I will bind up, the sick I will heal. But the sleek and the strong I will destroy, shepherding them rightly. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Pinagiginhawa ko lubos. himlayay, sariwang pastulan, ang pahingahan ko'y payapang batisan, hatid sa kaluluwa ay kaginhawaan sa tumpak na landas. Siya ang patnubay, ang Panginoon ang aking pastol, pinaginhawa ko lubos. Madilim na lambak man ang tatahakin ko, wala akong sinda, siya'y kasama ko. Ang hawak niyang tungkod ang siyang gabay ko, tanga niyang pamalo siglat ang bulan ko. Ang Panginoon ang aking pastol, pinaginhawa ko lubos.
The second reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person, one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. How much more then, since we are now justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath? Indeed, if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more, once reconciled, will we be saved by his life? Not only that, but we also boast of God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us all please rise to honor the gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The proclamation of the good news of our Lord according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus addressed this parable to the Pharisees and scribes. What man among you, having 100 sheep and losing one of them, would not leave the 99 in the desert and go after the lost one until he finds it? And when he does find it, he sets it on his shoulders with great joy. And upon his arrival home, he calls together his friends and neighbors and says to them, "Rejoice with me, because I have found my lost sheep. I tell you, in just the same way, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous people who have no need of repentance." Friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for the homily.
Parang kamakailan lamang yon, isang taon na ang nakalipas at naririto tayo muli. Maraming salamat sa inyong pagdalo. Nagkataon na ngayon ay kapistahan ng banal na puso ni Jesus, Sacred Heart. Kaya gusto kong sanang pagnilayan natin ang tungkol sa matters of the heart. Pero kung kilala natin si Noynoy, hindi siguro puso ang pag-uusapan. Gayunpaman, sa kapistahang ito ng banal na puso ni Jesus, ating idalangin ang isa't isa para ating maunawaan at maibahagi sa ating kapwa ang pinakakahulugan ng ating debosyon sa pag-ibig ng puso ni Jesus. Ang larawan ng Sacred Heart ay pusong hindi itinatago. Puso itong inilalabas sa dibdib. Paalala na may puso ang Diyos. May puso ang tao. At ang puso ng Diyos, puso rin ng tao. Maraming layaw ang puso ng tao. Madalas maligaw. Kung sino-sino ang sinasanto, hati, marupok, babasagin, broken-hearted, ika nga ni Pinoy noong nakaraang taon. Pero ang paalala ng Sacred Heart, sagrado ang puso. Sagrado ang puso ng tao dahil sagrado ito sa Diyos. Ang tibok ng puso ng tao ay tibok mismo ng puso ng Diyos. Ang larawan ng Sacred Heart ay pusong pinaiikutan ng tinik, thorns. Minsan may krus na nakatanim sa taas. Paalala sa atin na ang puso ng Diyos, tulad ng puso ng tao, nagagalusan, dumudugo, nabibigo. Maraming tinik sa puso ng tao. Masakit magmahal. Walang pagmamahal na hindi mahapdi. Walang pagmamahal na hindi pinipiga ng tinik. Ang pagmamahal na hindi nasusubukan, ang pagmamahal na walang luha, mura lamang, mura sa lansangan. Mahal ang tunay na pagmamahal. Lalo pa yung radikal na pagmamahal. hindi na bibili, hindi na sisilaw. Dinidibdib ang minamahal at ang dapat mahalin. Di naabala sa lait o suklam. Di alintana ang masuklian. Radikal, dahil kusang loob sa pag-aalala at pagsabay sa nilimot ng lipunan. Maraming tinik sa puso ng tao, pero paalala ng Sacred Heart, sagrado ang puso. Kahit nababasagin at broken-hearted, kahit palibutan pa ng maraming tinik, ang pusong dumudugo at nabibigo, ang pusong naghahain ng buhay, kawangis nito, ang puso ng Diyos na sa krus nakabayubay. Ang larawan ng Sacred Heart ay hindi lamang pusong pinupulupitan ng tinik. Puso din itong dinapuan ng apoy, nagbabaga. Ang Sacred Heart ay pusong nagliliyab, hindi nauupos, walang panlalamig. Paalala sa atin na huwag yumabang. Sa totoo lang, wala tayong kakayahan na sindihan ang sariling liwanag. Paalala rin na huwag tuluyang mawalan ng loob. Mula naman sa pag-ibig ng Diyos ang sindi ng ating puso. At walang pananamlay ang liyab ng kanyang puso. May init ang pusong nagmamahal. May liwanag at linaw. Inaawit natin, alab ng puso, sa dibdib mo'y buhay. Walang pagmamanhid, walang lamig sa pusong nag-aalab at buhay. Sagrado ang pusong inilalabas sa dibdib at dilim. Nangangahas pa ring umasa at magtaya. Sagrado ang pusong may tapang na kumilos alang-alang sa napupusuan ng Diyos para sa kanyang sinisintang bayan. Ano nga ba? Sino nga ba ang napupusuan ng Diyos? Sa Ebanghelyo, malinaw. Ang puso ng mabuting pastol ay wala gaano sa 99% sa nakararami na manhid at hindi magawang magsisi. Nasa 1% ang puso ng Diyos sa nawawala at nawawalan. Silang said at walang makapitan, kundi ang Diyos na kanilang inaasahan at pinanaligan. There will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous people who have no need of repentance. Sila ang napupusuan ng mabuting pastol. Para sa kanila, nag-aalab ang puso ng Diyos. Sa kapistahang ito ng banal na puso ni Jesus, Ipinagdiriwang din natin ang unang taon ng pag-alala kay Noynoy. Kung kapiling pa natin si Noy, hula ko lang. Hindi puso ang ating pag-uusapan. Magkwekwentuhan muna tayo ng kung ano-ano, kalaunan, seseryoso ang usapan, dadako sa inang bayan. Matters of state muna, bago matters of the heart. Kung sakasakaling magkapuwang, sasaglit ang malalim na katahimikan. Sasagi sa alaala ang maraming tinik at apoy na pinagdaanan ng pusong nasubukan. Mapapahinto, mapapatanong sa sarili, itatanong sa iyo ang tanong din ng Diyos sa kanya, para saan? Para kanino mo tiniis ang tinik sa puso? Para saan? Para kanino ang alab ng iyong puso? Balang araw, tangan lamang ang tinik at apoy na pinagdaanan, mangyari sanang masagot natin ang Diyos at sarili ng masinsinan.
Please stand.
Let us now profess our faith. Let us say together the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen. We can pray to the Father with great confidence because in Christ he has set his heart upon us. Trusting in God's love, we pray, fill us with your love, Lord. Please repeat.
Fill us with your love, Lord.
For all shepherds of the church, all who care for the flock of Christ, that they may shepherd them rightly, leading them to good pastures of truth and goodness, we pray.
Fill us with your love, Lord.
For peace throughout the world, that God may raise up leaders after his own heart, who will do what is fair and just in his sight, we pray.
Fill us with your love, Lord.
For all Filipinos, that we may be the hands of Jesus, reaching out to heal the sick and bind up the injured, but especially to seek out the strayed and the lost, and bring them home to the Father in jubilation with our Savior. We pray.
Fill us with your love, Lord.
For those who are sick and burdened, who are bereaved or in any distress, especially Christina Bernadette, that they may be among the meek and humble of heart, whom God comforts by revealing the secrets of His love, we pray.
Fill us with your love, Lord.
For all who are in need of God's loving kindness, especially those who have asked for our prayers in a difficult time, that the love of God may be poured out in their hearts through the Holy Spirit, we pray.
Fill us with your love, Lord.
That we may offer to our Savior the courtesy of our firm belief in the love of His sacred heart, and return to Him the consecration of our own hearts to works of love in His name, we pray.
Fill us with your love, Lord.
For our faithful departed, especially Benigno Simeon, who have been justified by the blood of Jesus, that He may now share His life with them in everlasting joy, we pray.
Fill us with your love, Lord.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns and our personal intentions.
Merciful Father, receive these prayers we offer in union with the pierced heart of your beloved Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated for the preparation of the altar and the gifts. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Look, O Lord, we pray, on the surpassing charity in the heart of your beloved Son, that what we offer may be a gift acceptable to you and an expiation of our offenses, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, He gave Himself up for us with a wonderful love and poured out blood and water from His pierced side, the wellspring of the Church's sacraments, so that won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember your servant, Benigno Simeon, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all of that in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all your saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Please stand.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to pray. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Please kneel.
Behold Jesus, whose heart is full of love and mercy. Happy are we who are invited to his sacred meal.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. We now join our brothers and sisters who are with us online in praying the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. For an orderly distribution of Holy Communion in the church, kindly remain in your seats until the ministers have reached their posts. Please form one line and observe physical distancing at all times.
Compassion that I may be your heart today. Strength, grant unto me compassion that I may be your heart today. Mahal na puso ni Jesus, kami ay iyong kupkupin at akitin ang puso namin ng grasya mo. O Kristo, dinggin aming panalangin. Laging ang kinin ang puso namin.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May the sacrament of charity, O Lord, make us fervent with the fire of holy love, so that drawn always to your Son, we may learn to see him in our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for some announcements and acknowledgments. Our sincere gratitude to the following for their active participation in the commemoration of the first death anniversary of President Benigno Simeon Aquino III. Father Babiap S.J., President of the Ateneo de Manila University, our presider. Thank you, Father. Father Jet Villarin S.J., our homilist. The concelebrants are Jesuit Fathers, our choir, the Ninoy and Cory Aquino Foundation, or NCAF, for sharing their gifts of music. Our readers, servers, and offerers. The Aquino family, the friends and classmates of Pinoy. All the public servants who, with Pinoy, unselfishly served the Filipino people for 6 years. We would also like to thank the men and women from the various offices in the Ateneo who were responsible in making this a meaningful Eucharistic celebration. After the Mass, you are invited to partake of some light refreshments in front of the church. We now call on the President of the Ateneo, Father Bobby Yap, for some words.
Noynoy was a true blue Atenean. Completing his elementary, high school, and college education here in Ateneo de Manila. Grade school 73, high school 77, AB Economics 81. He was also an avid Blue Eagles fan and came home to Loyola Heights numerous times throughout his career as a public servant. President Noy considered Ateneo de Manila as a safe haven during his lifetime, from his days as a student and up to his days as the country's leading public servant. In his message to the graduating class of the Loyola Schools in 2016, which coincidentally was his last official speech as president, he exhorted Ateneans to fully engage with society, to truly go down the hill and become agents of change willed by faith. Hindi tayo nagsanay para lang magkulong sa isang ivory tower. Hindi para sa sarili lang ang tuon ng kaalamang nakalap natin dito. Down from the hill, kasama kahalubilo ng ating mga kapwa upang maging kasangkapan ng Panginoon, palagi sa kapwa ang tuon sa kalakhang mundo. Dahil tayo ay men and women for others. His message was based on his experience in public service as Tarlac representative, senator, and eventually president. His words ring true to this day as we all face a truly complex and uncertain future. Despite the ups and downs of his term, he will be remembered as a president who showed our nation and the world how leadership with competence, conscience, compassion, and commitment can bring about a marked difference in the lives of millions of people. He will also be remembered for representing the Philippines with honor and dignity, elevating our country's status on the world stage. President Noy's love for our country and our people, especially the poor and the marginalized, is unquestionable. In the face of a planet in emergency mode, a chaotic political environment, wars in different places, disinformation and misinformation, and a heavily fractured society, we ask for President Noy's prayers that Ateneo and Ateneans become true beacons of God's light and love in our world. and that we will be steadfast in our commitment to walk with the excluded, to journey with the youth in creating a hope-filled future, and to care for creation, our common home. In closing, I would like to share that a few days after President Noy's burial, the classmates and friends of Noy started a fund campaign for the Benigno Simeon Aquino III Scholarship Endowment Fund. I am very happy to announce that after 1 year, 15 million has been raised. Which will allow many scholars from outside NCR to study for their college here in Ateneo de Manila. Thank you very much for those who organized the fund campaign and for the many donors and benefactors who gave to honor a true son of the Ateneo, President Noy, a man for others.
Thank you, Father Bobby. We now call on one of the members of the Aquino family, Mrs. Balsi Aquino Cruz, for her message.
Good morning, dear fathers, government officials, the members of Noy's cabinet, and all of you who were once Noy's bosses. Our family story has been compared to a roller coaster many times. We have had lots of highs and probably an equal number of lows. Our highs would be comparable to yours, but our lows were really extraordinary. There were times when we felt like we were a deadly virus, worse than COVID. Our mother bore the brunt of that, and later, Noy did. We learned the hard way that anyone can show up and celebrate with you when you're up there. But the ones who stay by your side when things are not going your way, they are your genuine friends. Kayong mga minsay pinagsilbihan ni Noy na naririto ngayon para gunitain ang anibersaryo ng kanyang pagsasakabilang buhay, kayo ang tunay na mga kaibigan. Wala pang naiimbentong panguri para maisalarawan ko sa inyo ang galak ng aming mga puso sa pakikiisa ninyo sa amin ngayong araw na ito. Taus-puso pong pasasalamat kina Father Bobby, Father Jet, Father Kit, Father Manuling, Father Jason, at lahat ng mga Hesuitang nakibahagi sa atin ngayon. Sa kina Jerry, Eddie, Bichik, Andy, Lito, Matik, at mga kabatch ni Noy na nag-organisa nitong pagtitipon na ito, sa kay Jerome at sa Gesù Liturgical Team, sa Jesuit Communications Team, sa kina Jampao at lahat ng kasama niya sa choir, sa kina Direk Maria, Susan at mga kasamahan ni Ninoy, sa pamalang Aquino at sa inyong lahat na patuloy na naaalala si Noy, pagpalain po kayo ng may kapal. A year ago, our hearts fell apart when Noy breathed his last. But we returned him to our Creator with gratitude for the blessing that he was. A simple, honest, self-effacing, and decent Filipino who gave his all without fanfare when he was tasked to serve his bosses. May I ask you to join me in considering what he said? And I quote, "May you always believe, just as I do, that the Filipino is really worth fighting for, that the Filipino will indeed rise up to the occasion, that God has a good plan for all of us, and this will take place in His time. Keep the faith. Know that this is just a phase. End of quote. Let me invite you now to watch the video entitled Minsan Kang Minahal, prepared by Maria Vargas Montelibano and her team upon the suggestion of Lito. Thank you very, very much again from Pinky, Viel, Chris, and our entire family.
Wala pa akong katuwang sa buhay. Kaya ang naging tuto ko lang ay ang taong bayan. Sa trabaho ito, para akong punching bag na tinapalan ng katakot-takot na duct tape. Pero hindi ako natinan dahil nasa likod ko kayo. Tunay ngang hindi ako nag-iisa.
Ano na lang yung isang sandali na makatikim ng pagmamahal matapos ang luhang ipinagpalit ang sandali di naman magtagal ang iyakap mo
Patuloy nating mapapatunayan na the Filipino is worth dying for. The Filipino is worth living for. At idagdag ko naman po, the Filipino is definitely worth fighting for.
Kasi para lang siya po yung pamilya ko.
Simple lang. Meron siyang isang driver, isang bodyguard, pero madalas siya po yung nagpamaneho ng sasakyan.
Hindi naman siya katulad ng ibang politiko na bawat litrato, titignan. Ayoko niya, titignan. Wala siya, hindi siya gano'n.
Tuminsan sa akin at kung ako ay malimutan.
Po natin. At ngayon, kitang-kita na ang layo ng ating narating. Ngayon,
Pilipino, ituloy natin ang pagkakapitbisig. Sabay nating arugain, pabilisin at palawakin ang transformasyon ng lipunan. Ako po, si Noynoy Aquino, ipinagmamalaki ko sa buong mundo, Pilipino ako, at talagang napakasarap maging Pilipino sa panahon ito. Maraming salamat po, maganda ka po sa lahat.
Okay, come on. Ha! The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. May the God of all consolation order your days in His peace and grant you the gifts of His blessing. Amen.
Amen.
May He free you always from every distress and confirm your hearts in His love. Amen.
Amen.
So that on life's journey you may be effective in good works, rich in the gifts of hope, faith, and charity, and may happily come to eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
And I ask my brother priest to join me in giving the blessing. And may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our Eucharist has been offered. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to run not go, that one man.
Teach us.